Hi everyone, this is Palak Vadariya from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. We will discuss our subject, that is Python programming, and here is our unit number 2, that is Python decision making and loops. And our today's topic is what? It's a for loop. In our earlier session, we just discussed about what? It's a while loop. Now let's start our today's session. So here, first of all, we will see the syntax that is we will use in a for loop. So here we will write for value in a sequence. So value, that is a VAL, that is what is a one variable. You can write any name, A, B, C, D, whatever you want. Okay, and a sequence, that means you can consider here the list or some range command. What is a range command? That we will discuss later. Right now you can see that here we can use what? It's a some sequence, that is some list or dictionary like that. When we want the one by one element from that, then it's a body for if. Okay, so body for loop. So here, when this one by one, it will take that, and whatever the operation that you want to perform, that you have to write down in the body of code. Now has the value, here the value is a variable that takes the value of the item inside the sequence of each iteration. Now the loop continues until we reach the last item in the sequence, and the body for the if loop is separated from the rest of the code using the indentation. So whether it is a if else or while loop, for loop, indentation is a must. And after like any conditional statement or loop, colon is must. Okay, if you don't write the colon, then you will get the sub error. Now, next we will see the flowchart. See here, so first of all, what will happen? The from each item in a sequence, and it will check, last item is reached? No. Then body for the code is executed, and again it will check, again take the next item. And it will see, it is the last item. If it is no, the process is continued. And if answer is yes, then it is the exit of the loop. Now next, see, to understand the for loop very well, we will discuss the sum code. Okay, here the for loop program to read, Python program to read a number n and print the identity matrix of the desired cells. See here, for example, n equal to what? It's a 4. Then I want the output like this. I want the identity matrix of a 4 cross 4. If user has entered the 3, then I want the identity matrix of 3 cross 3. Now we will discuss the program. As I say, here the user will enter the number. So n that equal to what? It's an integer. Input, and then it is what? It's a enter a number. Now here I use the range function. Okay, that is for I in a range 0 comma n. So what this function will do? 0 comma n. So here, for example, if n is 2, so it will give me the number from 0 and 1. It will not consider the last digit. Okay, if I n equal to 5, then this range function will give me the numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Why 0? Because I have specified it 0. Okay, if you are specifying that will be 1, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, it start is 0 and the last number that it will not have. Okay, so one by one it will take first 0, then 1, then 2, like that. Now here, again, I'm using the another for loop, because see, I want the identity matrix, or in the identity matrix, we know that there are some rows and columns. So one loop for the row and one loop, that is for the column. So now J is for the column. So J, that is changing 0 to L. Now we know when row is equal to column, at that time I want 1. Okay, first row, first column, second row, second column, third row, third column, like that. So here I will compare if the value of I and j is same. Okay, so for that I'll use the if. Then I want to print for 1. And if I not use the and, then everything I'll get in a straight line. But what I want space. First I want 1, then 0, then 0, like that. So it's a 1 and then AND with some space. Now, as what you want to do, you have to bring 0 with the space. Okay, so what will happen? First row, then you will get all the column. Then again 4 row. Second row, then 4 columns like that. And then finally you have to use the print function to print all together. Okay, so now if enter the file, then this is the output, right? Here you will get the identity matrix of 5 cross 5. Okay, now let's discuss the one more example. Now write a Python program to check the number has an odd count of an odd division and even count of an even division. That means what? Let me explain. Here, user has entered the number 36, then I want output yes. How? See the explanation. Here the division of 36 are what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18 and 36. Now, among all this division, you just identify how many of that even and how many of that are odd. So, odd are what? 1, 3, 9, that is 3. And 3 is itself it's an odd number. Now even is what? It's a 2, 4, 6, 12, 18 and 36 and summation, that is number of even division of what? It's a 6. And 6 itself it's an even number. That's why answer is yes. Now if I input n equal to 6, then answer is no because it's odd count division. Addition is not an odd number. And even is not an even number. Alright? So now let's write this code. Here first of all user will enter the number and that we need to convert into what? Integer. Now here I am just defining a one empty list. Why I want the empty list? Because first of all I want to store all the divisors inside that A list. And then I am going to separate it for the even and odd. So how I can get the division? If that number modulus, that remainder, if I get the remainder that equal to 0, that means that is the division for that number. Alright, so how I can check? Here I am taking a range from 1 to n plus 1. Because if my number is 5, then I have to check from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 itself. But we know in a range 5 will not count, so I will increase 1, 6. You right now you just think your number n equal to 5. So what will happen? This range is become 1, 2, 6. Because from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you have to check the number. You have to divide that with the number. Now here we will check the modulus function. If n is modulus of r and if it is equal to 0, that means that digit is a what? It's a division for the number n. So we will store that number in our empty list. So a dot append and that we want to append in our empty list I. Okay, a r. So it's a dot append and then it's a what I. Then now we have all the divisors in a list a. Now what we will do? Now we will check one by one divisor and we will check whether it is even or odd. So what's the way to find out whether that number is even or odd? Yes, it's correct. We will do the modulus operation of each and every element present in a list by 2. And if answer remainder is 0, that means it's a what? Even. Otherwise, it's a what? Odd number. So yes, I modulus of 2, if it is equal to 0, then store that is b equal to b plus 1. 1 count. We will going to increase the 1 count. So definitely I have to define the b 0. Now else take our variable c that equal to c plus 1. That means that is what? It's an odd number. And declare the c with the 0 like this. Now we want to check our more condition. We want to check b is even or c is odd. So for that here we will write if b modulus of 2 is equal to 0 and just recall our operator and. Okay, and c modulus of 2 is not equal to 0. Okay, that means b is an even and Z is the odd. Then simply I want to print yes, as I want to print no. So it's a very simple code. First store all the division in the list and then check for the even and odd part. Now next we will discuss that is a for loop with else. Now a for loop can have an optional else block as well. Now the else part is executed if the item in a sequence is used in a for loop is exhausted. That means last up. The break keyword can be used to stop the for loop. In such case, else part is ignored. See, like in a while also, we have discussed the same thing. While with the else. In that also, if we use the break statement inside the while, then else part is ignored. Here also the same thing. Now, to see this, we will discuss one example. That is, here the digits are what? 0, 1 and 5. I take one list and the name of the list is what as a digit? Now 4, I in a digits, okay, you just consider smaller, then print I, else print no item left. So what will happen? One by one it will check the items that is present in a digit and it will print it. So first it takes 0, then print 0, then 1, then print 1, 5, then print 5. Now there is no item left inside the digit. So the else part is executed. So if we see the output, that is what 0, 1, 5 and then after you will get no item left. Okay, so this is for how you can use the else in a for. So I hope today's session is clear. Thank you.